Good morning. We're so glad that you've chosen to worship with us in the Episcopal Diocese of Fort Worth for our fourth weekly communion for the month of October. I invite you now to take a deep breath, center yourself, and prepare for worship. Blessed be the one holy and living God. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, increase in us the gifts of faith, hope, and charity, that we may obtain what you promise. Make us love what you command. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to all the congregation of the people of Israel and say to them, 'You shall be holy, for I, the Lord your God, am holy. You shall not render an unjust judgment. You shall not be partial to the poor or defer to the great. With justice you shall judge your neighbor. You shall not go around as a slanderer among your people, and you shall not profit by the blood of your neighbor. I am the Lord. You shall not hate in your heart anyone of your kin. You shall reprove your neighbor, or you will incur guilt yourself. You shall not take vengeance or bear a grudge against any of your people, but you shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord." The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray in unison, Psalm 90. Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to another. Before the mountains were brought forth, or the land and the earth were born, from age to age you are God. You turn us back to the dust and say, "Go back, O child of earth." For 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday when it is past, and like a watch in the night. You sweep us away like a dream. We fade away suddenly like the grass. In the morning it is green and flourishes. In the evening it is dried up and withered. Return, O Lord, How long will you tarry? Be gracious to your servants. Satisfy us by your loving kindness in the morning. So shall we rejoice and be glad all the days of our life. Make us glad by the measure of the days you afflicted us, and the years in which we suffered adversity. Show us your servants, your works, and show your splendor to your children. May the graciousness of the Lord our God be upon us. Prosper the work of our hands. Prosper our handiwork.
A reading from 1 Thessalonians. You yourselves know, brothers and sisters, that our coming to you was not in vain, but though we had already suffered and been shamefully mistreated at Philippi, as you know, we had courage in our God to declare to you the gospel of God in spite of great opposition. For our appeal does not spring from deceit or impure motives or trickery, but just as we have been approved by God to be entrusted with the message of the gospel, even so we speak, not to please mortals, but to please God who tests our hearts. As you know, and as God is our witness, we never come with words of flattery or with a pretext for greed, nor did we seek praise from mortals, whether from you or from others, though we might have made demands as apostles of Christ. But we were gentle among you, like a nurse tenderly caring for her own children. So deeply do we care for you that we are determined to share with you not only the gospel of God, but also our own selves, because you have become very dear to us. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew. When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together and one of them, a lawyer, asked him a question to test him. "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to them, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and first commandment. And a second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." Now while the Pharisees were gathered together, Jesus asked them this question, "What do you think of the Messiah? Whose son is he?" They said to him, "The son of David." Jesus said to them, "How is it then that David, by the Spirit, calls him Lord, saying, 'The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I put your enemies under your feet'? If David thus calls him Lord, how can he be his son?" No one was able to give him an answer, nor from that day did anyone dare to ask him any more questions. The Gospel of the Lord. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be glorifying in your sight, O Lord, our God. Amen. I watched a documentary a few days ago that has stayed with me. It was visually stunning, beautiful beyond words. Not only has it caused me to give up calamari forever, but it's also caused me to consider love in a broader way. Craig Foster, documentarian, had lost hope and felt disconnected from his surroundings, unable to feel and express care for others. All he could think to do was to reconnect with what had been important earlier in his life, the ocean. In My Octopus Teacher, he engaged daily with his environment, noticing what was around him in the watery landscape, and in the process, developed a rather unusual relationship with an octopus that connected with him one small tentacle at a time. This documentary has been on my mind for a few reasons, primarily because it was a hauntingly beautiful and unusual story, but also because many of us are feeling hope diminish as we have been disconnected from our surroundings and our routines for the majority of 2020. Worldwide, we are in conflict about how best to care for God's creation, about whether climate change is real. This documentary is a powerful reminder of the beauty and complexity of creation and the importance of caring for our surroundings, whatever they may be. Care of creation is one way we can express love for our Creator. That is the foundation of our faith. Love God. In both our Old Testament and Gospel readings today, we hear that the most important thing we do is love God. And out of that love comes love neighbor and love self. We can distract ourselves by asking, who is my neighbor? Or we can grab on to the definition that neighbor has to do with proximity. Yes, your neighbor is the person living next door to you, but your neighbor is also the one in close proximity to you, at the post office, in the park, or at the polling place. Your neighbor is the one who looks like you, but also the one who looks different from you. If a man can learn to love again because he cared for an octopus, surely we can learn to love our neighbors, who are human beings in a vast array of colors. The whole of the book of Leviticus is about godly living, a code for holiness. Some people refer to only one or two verses in the entire book to take a stand on issues of human sexuality. But those same people inevitably ignore the remainder, saying it is outdated and meaningless. We only get a few verses today, but there are other interesting things about Leviticus. In chapters 18 to 20, the phrase, "I am the Lord," is used 24 times. 24 times in three chapters. I think we're supposed to get the point that God is God, and we are not. Also found in chapter 19, "You shall not round off your hair on your temples or mar the edges of your beard." Sorry, guys, but a goatee simply does not cut it. "You shall not tattoo any marks upon you." Now, I don't know what all of you sporting this new cultural phenomenon of tattoos are supposed to do, but I do know that God still adores you. Okay, younger people, this one is for you. "You shall rise before the aged and defer to the old." That calls out our cultural prejudice against the elderly. And believe me, I have experienced it simply by letting my natural hair color shine through.
Oh, and this one is good. When a foreigner lives with you in your land, do not take advantage of the foreigner. Treat the foreigner the same as a citizen. Love the foreigner like one of your own. Love the foreigner as yourself. That's a step even further than loving neighbor as self. We are called to love foreigners as well as ourselves. I think we may have some room to grow in this category, especially considering the 500 plus children still separated from their families at our borders since 2017. Mothers separated from their babies for 3 years. That is not loving the foreigner. The book of Leviticus doesn't leave much room for finger pointing. We all fall short of living perfectly. But if we keep love as our guiding force, we will create a better world. Today's gospel reminds us that love of neighbor is the way to true justice. Love of neighbor is the way true justice is made known. This is the summation of the Bible: loving God with all we are and all we have, and loving each other, loving ourselves. That is what Jesus was trying to tell the Pharisees, the Sadducees, and anyone else who would listen. Love God. Then love your neighbor like you love yourself. It was and is a lifelong endeavor. The infamous Rabbi Hillel of the first century BCE had an interesting exchange with a young Gentile who wanted to convert to Judaism and stated that the only way he would accept Judaism would be if a rabbi would teach him the entire Torah while he, the prospective convert, stood on one foot. The man went to Rabbi Hillel. Although it was a peculiar request, this gentle sage accepted the challenge and said, "What is despicable to you, do not do to your neighbor. That is the whole Torah. The rest is commentary. Go and study it." You likely recognize that as the golden rule in reverse: do unto others as you would have them do unto you. What is despicable to you, do not do to others. Imagine how you would feel if someone tormented you because of how you trim your beard, or how you tattoo your body, or because of who you love, or because you have lived long enough to earn a head of silver hair. Just pause for a moment to imagine. Imagine how it would feel to be treated unfairly simply because of the color of your skin, or because of a speech impediment, or because you are differently abled than the norm. What is despicable to you, do not do to others. Oh, and I almost forgot this verse: you shall reprove your neighbor, or you will incur guilt yourself. In other words, if we see something wrong, we need to say something. If we see something and fail to say something, we are as guilty as the perpetrator. If I see someone harassing a foreigner and ignore it, I am as guilty as the harasser. If I see someone taunting a person in the LGBTQ family and I fail to say something, I am guilty. If I hear a racial slur or observe an injustice but keep silent, I am equally to blame. This is a tall order. We must be rooted in our love of Creator, in love for God, in order to love our neighbors enough to stand up for them, in order to love ourselves enough to embody God's presence, peace, and mercy for each other. Dare to reach out, even one small tentacle at a time, like the octopus teacher. Dare to learn to love a neighbor you have not loved before. Dare to speak up for injustices that you have ignored. dare to be part of the revolution of love that will change the world for good.
I now invite you to stand as we join with our Christian neighbors from around the world in reaffirming our faith with the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In peace we pray to you, Lord God.
The prayers of the people. For all people in their daily life and work, for our family, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone, for this community, the nation, and the world, for all who work for justice, freedom, and peace, for the just and proper use of your creation, for the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression, for all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble, for those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy, for the peace and unity of the Church of God, for all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth, for Michael, our presiding bishop, and Scott, our bishop, and all bishops and other ministers, for all who serve God in his church, for the special needs and concerns of this congregation and diocese, Helen and Patrick Hayden, hear us, Lord, for your mercy is great. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life, for the rainfall. We will exalt you, O God, our King, and praise your name forever and ever. We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them who put their trust in you.
We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. And now may the peace of the Lord be always with you. What follows next is Holy Communion, and all are invited to God's table. So whether this is your first week worshiping with us, or you've been worshiping in our churches for years, know that you are invited, because it is not me who invites you here, it is God. If you have received a consecrated wafer from your church, now is the time to prepare your home altar before you. If you do not have a consecrated wafer, we invite you to participate through spiritual communion. The prayer is found at the end of our communion prayer. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Our service continues with Eucharistic Prayer B. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Because in the mystery of the Word made flesh, you have caused a new light to shine in our hearts, to give the knowledge of your glory in the face of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the Word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with the Blessed Virgin Mary and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your children. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
These are the gifts of God for you, the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Amen.
The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, O God, Send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier, be with you today and remain with you always.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.